Hello everyone, my name is Artem Pervushin and this channel is all about trading in the cryptocurrency market. Today, I'm recording a live broadcast on my YouTube channel where I primarily want to focus on risk management. I'll be showing you real trade examples, pinpointing the spots where I marked a loss, including unprofitable trades. I'll tell you why I decided to mark them there. I'll show you both successful and unsuccessful trades. And by successful, I don't just mean those that closed in the plus, but also negative trades which can be successful if I've set an appropriate stop loss. Essentially, what's important is that the losses are effectively limited. One of the reasons I chose to discuss this today was due to recent messages I've received. I get quite a few of these messages, often a couple times a week. Some people continuously write to me. But something really drove me to finally delve into this topic. They write, "Leaked deposit leaked. It's impossible to drain a deposit on the exchange if you know how to work with risks." That's why I've started this broadcast. We're going to learn how to work with risks, and I'll show you the results of an experiment where I'm boosting an account. In fact, this is the second part of the account boosting series. I want to remind you that the first part is available on this YouTube channel where I analyzed the first four transactions. The account was already quite strong, and the transactions were perfect. However, quite a lot of time has passed since then. There have been quite a few transactions. I'll be analyzing every transaction using examples today. Also, those of you watching online can type your questions into chat. I'll be checking in periodically to see what you've written. So, let's start by taking a look at the account balance and the transactions. Right now, I have a live transaction open with a $92 panel hanging there. But we'll revisit that at the very end as it's the last in line. I analyzed four transactions on YouTube, and from the fifth, we'll catch up to the present moment. But first, I want to show you this chart and importantly, the account balance of $300. You can assess the trading results, but there's a catch. This figure does not reflect reality as the statistics on this page is updated with a delay of 24 hours. So, the technical information made over the last 24 hours are not displayed here. But these transactions are listed below, and you'll see a lot of red ones. I'll be talking in detail about them today, and we'll pay more attention to them than the green profitable ones. The result is a little less than what you currently see on the screen. Recently, there have been, not a lot, but some losing trades. Initially, the results were perfect, all green. I analyzed the first four trades in the past. Start in order with ADA. I've actually traded a lot of NEO lately, and NEO has spoiled my stats with a bit of a total negative for NEO. So the red flag started here. We'll start with the deal on ADA, and before I clear it up, I'll start analyzing trades and put a focus on the following point for complete beginners who don't understand anything about trading. What is risk management? In the context of trading, when you enter a deal, let's say I opened a chart, I like it, price is rising, I understand that crypto is quite cheap now, in 15,000 years it will be worth millions of dollars. If I invest $3 now, I'll get rich. Great, I invest my last $3. What should I consider? I must, if I'm trading, set stop losses, that is, if the price goes against me. For example, I buy, but the price goes down if I don't bet. If I don't limit my loss with stop losses, my loss will equal my entire balance at some point. There may indeed be a situation where I'm buying a coin now. It drops and my balance has nothing left at all, zero on my balance sheet. This is exactly why reports of liquidations inspired me to conduct this live broadcast. Primarily, we need to figure out how, where, and why to place stop losses. It would seem this could happen. A thought in a beginner's head. Why, if the price is falling, if I'm in the minus, why should I record this minus? Until I have recorded, I'm not in the minus. Well, I'll sell it there with a plus in 2 years, I'll sit for 2 years. But the fact is that if you are engaged in trading and not passive investments, trading assumes it is implied that you'll use leverage, because without it, you'll earn just pennies. Practically nothing can be earned without leverage. With leverage, though, there is also a thing called liquidation. Essentially, if Bitcoin falls to zero, for example, it's priced at $1 and I bought 15 Bitcoins for $40,000. Well, I haven't sold yet technically, I haven't lost my millions, but if I fix it at one, I'll be in the red. However, with leverage, I won't be able to wait until Bitcoin costs $1. Some Bitcoins will be left in my balance. I'll encounter a situation where, when this price of Bitcoin passes, for example, here my balance remains exactly zero. Accordingly, to prevent such a situation, I must limit my loss somewhere. So this is where we limit losses. Broadly speaking, I, for instance, am entering a trade here for some reason. About the reasons for entering a deal, I'll tell you later. Yes, but let's say there's some reason for entering the deal. If my idea, the one I entered the deal with, doesn't pan out, and I understand that it's not panning out, some crap happens, I immediately bail on this deal. I'm closing it, and I'm not afraid of locking in a loss, so pay attention to the balance, let me go to the exchange, I have $1,200 in my balance, I started ramping up this account from $300, let me remind you, it was recently $1,500. So I'm slightly down, like how I flew away, but I'm not afraid of losing $300. I'm afraid of not setting stop losses. And if I'm wrong in a deal, for instance, I'm in a deal right now, I make money from the price rising, if it suddenly... I'm scared of losing my entire balance, which is quite possible, given that for high interest rates, and I've done times four, actually, I've added to my balance by now, I want to increase it even more, but for such interest rates, I use leverage. So I now have a position with a tenth leverage. That is, in fact, if the price of cryptocurrency drops by 10% and I'm in a trade, I lose everything. So I set a stop loss where my trade's logic ends, the logic of my trade. Yes, and at this moment, let's look at each of my transactions in order. Let's move on to hell. And yes, all this time, I'll show transactions on futures. I don't sit in spot. I don't trade spot. Spot also has a margin trading function, but there, and the commissions are higher, significantly higher, an order of magnitude higher. It's inconvenient from an interface point of view, not intuitive. And in general, it's not worth going there. Spot is... It's about income. At the moment when you see some kind of movement, grab this movement, make money. It doesn't matter if it's falling or growing. You can earn money from any movement if you know how to trade. If you don't know how to trade, you can lose from any movement, even from growth. So we go to hell, and here I'm on Bybit. On Bybit, I trade, there is such an interesting thing, interesting functionality with demonstration of my purchases and my sales. So I had a deal, now I'll check by date. Was it really that deal on December 12? Let's go back. Yes, December 12, that is, starting with this deal. By the way, no, I'm lying. I think I also discussed this deal in the last video on YouTube, but let's start with it. In any case, now it is very revealing. It is very good, ideal, by the way. If someone watched the last video on YouTube, I noticed that all the transactions that I analyzed then were ideal. Even there was one unprofitable one. It was also good, ideal. Those deals, those trades that I will show you now, they will be of worse quality because they are ideal entry points. Well, maybe I could have entered a couple more deals in 2 weeks. I might have had to skip the rest. Ideal entry points are quite rare. I initially tried not to take such mediocre transactions here, but later, I decided to give it a try. I didn't manage to quadruple the balance again, of course, but generally it was adequate. This is an ideal trade. Let's start with it. I'll outline what happened, why I entered the trade, where I limited the loss, and why I secured a profit. Now, what happened? The price dropped and the whole market was falling. I noticed the formation of a bottom. You see this candle? We can see there was a vertical decline. This was market-wide. And exactly half of this drop was immediately bought back. Everything that people were selling here indicates that there is already some kind of buyer here. The price initially fell because there wasn't any buyer here. and the seller swooped in, he swiftly pushed the market. A buyer appeared here, they quickly bought it, and the price holds. They bought most of the movement. This is a good sign. And then we update the bottom. We try to at least fly lower. And here is confirmation of the presence of a buyer. We bought up the ascending lows. If you look at the shadow of the candle and the level, I always trade from levels and their breakouts. I saw a clear level after the breakout, of which I understand that these buyers will drive the price up, as sellers have already sold everything they wanted. Everything they possibly could have sold, there's not much left to sell. Buyers, if they appear here, then after the level is broken, it could be a very good trade. Ascending lows, bottom level, level breakout. There was a retest here. I'm currently on the hourly chart. The deal was actually made on a 15-minute frame. Let me now switch to 15 minutes and show you. From this level, I traded the level. There were two false breakouts, after which I discerned this level. I also determined it after false breakouts. They didn't go below it. From here, they started to buy back, ascending lows, breakout of the level, consolidation, finally, the third time level retest. On this retest, I entered, bought, and I left the stop loss exactly for this level, a very short, small stop loss. Why is it there? If I'm wrong and my idea doesn't hold up, in this case, my idea was that after the level is broken, the buyer begins to drive the price up, we return to the top, the market must be strong. At this moment, I'm looking at all the other coins on the market and see that many are skyrocketing. They've already taken off, haven't yet taken off. They're at the retest. I confidently buy, I see that the market is strongly buying it, but if suddenly I turn out to be wrong, and regardless if the price plummets, it will somehow begin to move. This could be the start of a vertical movement. No, I'm closing the deal. How can I be sure that my idea didn't pay off if they break through this nearest level from which the buyers start to buy back? I put a stop loss for it. As you can see, they didn't reach it. This is a very small stop loss. It's rare to put such a small one. So I actually placed it and instantly the price moved in my favor. And I don't remember where I set the take profit. I closed it myself, not using the take. I closed it manually when I noticed the sellers. So here is a triple top, or there is a shoulder head, a reversal pattern, a level of a reversal pattern. Generally, after a breakout of this level, you need to sell. I think I left a little early. Well, over here somewhere, I was selling. In my opinion, I didn't wait for this breakout. I recorded such a good move, I earned as much as I can from it. I earned $316, essentially, plus the initial deposit. So let me switch off now for a couple of minutes. I won't switch off. Instead, I'll switch to your message in the chat. Who is watching me? 159 people? Great. Write a plus sign in the chat if you're online, so I understand. 159 people are sitting AFK, or they still want to learn something. Hello, since I turned 13 years old, you inspired me. Thanks to you, I can now analyze the market on my own and enter transactions, stealing money at the age of 16. Handsome. Hello, Artyom. During the broadcast, I ask you to name the entry and closing prices on the screen. Nothing is visible, but okay, good. But it's not really important what the price is. What's important is to understand the patterns, movements, and logic of trades. The price here can be any. And if you are talking about some current transactions, yes, I understand that this can be important. You might want to open something like this. Yes, I will pay separate attention to this, but in the past, don't focus too much attention on this. But I came online for this specifically. Handsome, I've always wondered, why is crypto not Forex? Currency-wise, what are the advantages? Please answer for Forex. I don't know how to trade in crypto. I do know how to trade, thus crypto. Why crypto and not Forex? Because it's easier and more accessible. Forex is just some Forex brokers who will just cheat you out of money. And I don't think that you will find a normal one there, as there is no exchange. In fact, yes, you will trade it through some intermediary brokers. Just Google many stories of how people got cheated by brokers, how to use trading, horizontal volumes, and what indicator do you use? In terms of indicators, I use only moving averages and volumes. I occasionally turn on horizontal volumes. That's the name of it. It's just an indicator in PVR. And by the way, no, in Russian it's just called horizontal volumes, an indicator of horizontal volumes. индикатор горизонтальных объемов,
анализ. Тикон, I'm closing the deal. How can I be sure that my idea didn't pay off if they break through this nearest level from which the buyers start to buy back? I put a stop loss for it. As you can see, they didn't reach it. This is a very small stop loss. It's rare to put such a small one. So I actually placed it and instantly the price moved in my favor. And I don't remember where I set the take profit. I closed it myself, not using the take. I closed it manually when I noticed the sellers. So here is a triple top, or there is a shoulder head, a reversal pattern, a level of a reversal pattern. Generally, after a breakout of this level, you need to sell. I think I left a little early. Well, over here somewhere, I was selling. In my opinion, I didn't wait for this breakout. I recorded such a good move, I earned as much as I can from it. I earned $316, essentially, plus the initial deposit. So let me switch off now for a couple of minutes. I won't switch off. Instead, I'll switch to your message in the chat. Who is watching me? 159 people? Great. Write a plus sign in the chat if you are online, so I understand. 159 people are sitting AFK, or they still want to learn something. Hello, since I turned 13 years old, you inspired me. Thanks to you, I can now analyze the market on my own and enter transactions, stealing money at the age of 16. Handsome. Hello, Artyom. During the broadcast, I ask you to name the entry and closing prices on the screen. Nothing is visible, but okay, good. But it's not really important what the price is. What's important is to understand the patterns, movements, and logic of trades. The price here can be any. And if you are talking about some current transactions, yes, I understand that this can be important. You might want to open something like this. Yes, I will pay separate attention to this, but in the past, don't focus too much attention on this. But I came online for this specifically. Handsome, I've always wondered, why is crypto not Forex? Currency-wise, what are the advantages? Please answer for Forex. I don't know how to trade in crypto. I do know how to trade, thus crypto. Why crypto and not Forex? Because it's easier and more accessible. Forex is just some Forex brokers who will just cheat you out of money. And I don't think that you will find a normal one there, as there is no exchange. In fact, yes, you will trade it through some intermediary brokers. Just Google many stories of how people got cheated by brokers, how to use trading, horizontal volumes, and what indicator do you use? In terms of indicators, I use only moving averages and volumes. I occasionally turn on horizontal volumes. That's the name of it. It's just an indicator in PVR. And by the way, no, in Russian it's just called horizontal volumes, an indicator of horizontal volumes. Tikon, turns out by date it was December 20th. December 20th, here I have, here he sat down, found it, here I had an entry point, and this is an exit point. You see, they are at the same level. What happened? The deal was good, the deal was profitable at the moment. You see, the price went in my favor, but then the market began to buy back. I'll better explain what happened through TradingView for me. It's just noted here about the throne. What happened to the throne? At this moment, and pay attention, I shorted the throne. That is, this trade was short, meaning when I short, I make money from the fact that the coin falls, and if it grows, I will lose money. I say such banal things because the newbies are also looking. What happened to the throne? It was about here. Well, a little later, and then on December 15th, I saw a bearish engulfing. So look, but growth, an upward trend under the ruler, a trend line, and look here, a triple top, descending tops, a reversal pattern, large volumes. Volumes are not visible here behind my camera. Yes, well, you see large volumes, that is, they are selling a lot here. The trend is broken. Well, I don't have a trend here, let me highlight it. But here it is. The trend is broken, the moving average is broken, bearish engulfing. This all coincided with volatility in the market as a whole. That is, here was the situation in the market as a whole. While Bitcoin was in a flat, a wimp was drawn, from which the exit was both up and down,
and was trading for a breakout, and coins like the throne, there were a couple of other coins that drew reversal, clear reversal patterns. It broke through with bearish engulfing. Then it was like a small rebound and a new bearish engulfing down here. It was bought back at the moment. Yes, the price has risen a little, in fact. This is the entry point for shorting. Good, excellent. No, by the way, I didn't deceive you on purpose. I didn't come in on the 20th. I closed on the 20th. From this move, I already made money on this movement. I was already in the position. I opened when I opened. I opened on December 15th, right here on the bearish engulfing, and here on the bearish engulfing I opened. This is a good entry point for shorting, and not ideal from the point of view that the market as a whole is bullish. The trend is upward. Shorting in such a market is bad. Why? Because you'll simply earn less than with long trades. You'll lose more than with long trades because it's a counter trend trade. But it's a 1 in a million trade. If it works, you're in great profit. That is why I didn't take profits here. Was it good? Because indicator of horizontal volumes, technical analysis. Listen, I don't even know how to turn it on. I have it turned on. Well, here's the name. And VRVP, I wrote VP incorrectly. This is how you will have horizontal volumes. Here is the volume profile of the visible area. Here you will have it. Write it down, or you will have it like this. And like this. Available with a subscription, yes. With a subscription to TRA, horizontal volumes are available. And I'm right now in a deal with ADA, but great. Congratulations, I hope it's going in the right direction. There is an alternative without a subscription. Less convenient, so, okay, no questions yet. I completed your course. I'm enjoying it. Mikhail, write about the results, by the way. During this live broadcast, I will invite you to training because I'm recruiting. And the class is already... The third class is underway. I haven't made announcements anywhere. I decided to recruit the third class among those who write to me in direct messages. My direct messages are simply full. Artyom, take it to the training. I sent everyone there a link to the pre-registration sheet, but perhaps someone missed it, who didn't see me during this live broadcast, or whoever watches the recording and doesn't follow my Instagram. I will invite you to the third class during the broadcast. If you'd like to sign up, so why is it crypto and not Forex? What advantage can you not make money on Forex? You will earn priority, in short. Otherwise, let's move on. Figure it out further. Tron, a deal of plus $2. What is it? Why plus $2? What a strange number. I closed at break even. And one more rule when you trade, for example, yes, I have some kind of conditional ADA open, for example, I buy from a breakout of a level, the price went here, I bought here, I placed a stop loss here after one level there. Yes, the closest one, which broke through after one. Here's the stop loss. Here the price is gone. In my favor, I'm already in the black grade. Somewhere around here, I want to take a profit, and the price has already gone in my favor. Now in this example, there is no reason for this yet. But suddenly the price starts to stall here and continues to move further. That is, a new level is formed. When a new level is formed, I move the stop loss through one level in my favor. That is, let's say the price goes in a similar way. At the moment, I understand that another level has formed. My stop loss always stands through one level. That is, since the level is the next one, and through this level under this, I will have a stop loss. And this is approximately the entry point. So this trade is the patron. It was closed at break-even. Let me open the Tron, show you how it was in practice. TRX, by the way. In case anyone hasn't switched to Vibit yet, the link is in the description. There they give you $100 for a deposit. The potential of such a deal, if my idea works out, is great. Here the coin could easily drop by another 10 to 15%. It could even go somewhere lower, which might be too low, like maybe around 10% drop. But here's the range of 10 to 15, there would be a profit. Just double from the balance right away, maybe even triple, essentially, what I want to convey. And people ask me in direct messages, Artyom, what's your percentage of profitable trades? There has always been a guideline of approximately 30% of profitable trades. Recently, it turns out to be 60%, which is interesting because even on this account, I have 60% of profitable trades.
And then an immediate question arises in response in direct messages. Wait, 30%? Are you even making money? How is that possible? You must be sitting in the red. And I reply that the funny thing is you can close almost all trades in the red. For example, you might have, I don't know, let's say 30% profitable trades, but if you, from each trade you lose about $50, with a profitable one, you take back $250. With 30% of successful trades, you will trade in profit. What is important is the ratio of your risk to profit. That's it. This trade is good from the point of view of the entry point, risky in terms of trend direction, potentially extremely profitable if I'm really right, and the market turns around and corrects. Just like that, I had this idea about a stop loss for a return here in this trend when the price started going. I immediately moved the stop loss to break even. Because, well, if the price comes back, that's what happened. Let them redeem the still rising bottom. They also bought it quite well. Plus there is volume, plus a shadow. That's it. My idea can be abandoned. It happened. I closed at break even. Here's a very small frame of 15 minutes. Let me open it in an hour. I'll show you how it happened. Here I opened it. There is my level. Designated. Approach this level. Approach confidently. Just hard takeovers. I immediately opened up, without waiting for the level to break through. I sometimes like to do this, it's more risky, more often deals. When I open them in advance before the level is broken, they often close in the footsteps. But if they are closed by techers, I take much more profit. So it opened here a little earlier. The level has been broken. The price did not go down too much right away. I formed it. Well, I didn't form it. Noted. Here's the next level, from which they pulled back. I had a stop loss, in my opinion, here behind these tops in Hayamiya. I could be wrong, but it seems like I had a stop loss there. And the second time this level was broken, the price has started to move. Well, here I already saw on this farm that the market is strong enough. And here a reversal pattern is already formed. Here such a wedge has formed. And when leaving this wedge, here I have break even actually. And I was knocked out. Broke even, in fact. I positioned a break-even under this level. The deal was good. You could make money and take the profit. I didn't do this because the potential was much greater if the idea had worked. However, the idea didn't work. The idea was a pullback in the market, but the market didn't pull back. The Tron coin was weak in particular, but the bet was essentially on a pullback in the whole market. Bitcoin was bought, however, it didn't fall. The coin was weak. And it was bought too because the market saw that it seemed like Bitcoin wasn't pulling back. They weren't selling it much. The same Tron was already corrected from the top. Buyers are starting to come in 10% cheaper, and sellers no longer want to sell here. The coin is oversold relative to the market, and it eventually recovered. I closed at a break-even. The deal is good. It will go well in general. Let's move on. This is where it begins. In my opinion. In my opinion, according to NEO, the first deal was ideal relative to others. Then there were deals that I took like 50-50 just so there were more deals, more entry points, and so I could analyze not only those examples from before. There were transactions before this, even this Tron, they are essentially identical, pattern similar at the bottom, the level, the breakdown of the level, entering the trade. The trade is in the black. Here are slightly different situations. Let's start with NEO with the first transaction. It took place on December 20th. Well, I closed it, or rather on December 20th. I'll show you what happened there. At this moment, I'll look in the chat, right in the chat. What questions do you have? Based on what I just told you, what is the horizontal volume for? You can set a level based on it. In general, there's nothing to it. You can use vertical volumes to calmly analyze the market. The levels on the market are already visible. You can place the levels on it exactly. How to read the volumes correctly is a topic for a separate broadcast. I won't dwell on it much. But remember this question. At the end of the broadcast, I'll try to answer all the questions. Whoever watches to the end, there won't be so many people, there won't be so many questions. I think I can allocate time for all the remaining questions. Remember this question right towards the end. I think I'll figure it out, not in super detail, but in general, I think the question should be closed. From $300, it's now $2,000.
$2,500. Mikhail Blokin, when did you take the course? I didn't mix anything up. Did you complete the course? But mine was $300. It became $2,500 when I passed it recently or bought it a long time ago. What if? If you have written to Misha, our curator, recently, I think we can accommodate you. Vitaly, it's a shame that only two indicators can be added on the free tariff. We need moving averages. A moving average can be added as a single indicator. Here I have four moving averages. This is the name of the MA Rebor indicator. Well, here are four moving averages all at once. So why not make money on Forex? I'm already making money. That's great. I think I could earn more with crypto. The market allows for fantastic results right now. That's true. Oh, this is Misha writing to us, our curator. Artyom, please tell us in more detail why crypto is better than Forex. I've been in Forex for a while. I don't have a stable income. We wanted to hear your opinion on crypto. As for why crypto is better than Forex, I'm in Forex. I haven't traded. I've only heard about it superficially. Forex is essentially the currency market. And the interbank market, they won't just let you in there. In Forex, in order to really trade on real Forex, you must have your own bank, supposedly with huge capital, billions of dollars. And you actually trade through intermediaries, through Forex brokers. They don't send your transactions to the market. They don't process it at all. That is, what you poke at the broker is most likely an illusion of trading. You just place a bet against the broker. The broker uses some tricks somewhere. He will squeeze you. What happened in the market with another broker didn't happen, or it didn't happen in the market itself. Some way the commission will go up, slippage of some sort will work. It seems you entered the market. It means you got fulfilled there. It is a closed market. It is a currency market. It is a market of enormous amounts of money. Technical analysis does not work there in the sense that the patterns from the point of view of market mechanics, from the point of view of crowd behavior, they do not work. There's simply no crowd there. You can find trends there and some sideways movement. You can try to trade something there, but essentially, your results on crypto would be 50 times better. Try trading on crypto, compare it yourself, then you'll say, yes, there will be a guide on how to choose coins. That's a good question, but more on that a little later. Let me show you Neo first. And there will be a guide. It will be cut off like someone's penis when I'm writing well. Does a gamer show up for trading? I think that 10 years from now, maybe theoretically. But I don't watch the diver on the RSI too often. Misha, though, from the optimal one in May, a handsome fellow managed to open it on YouTube. Thank you so much for the broadcast. I've already decided that I'll pop in for some training. We kindly ask you to please save the broadcast for at least a few hours. As at work, we only listen to the audio without video. I will definitely save it, yes. But I think I'll trim it so it hasn't been lying around here on YouTube for several hours. A lot of people have had their licenses revoked by scam. Misha writes, well, yes, yes, well, from the comments, good point. Once again, how to choose coins and how to read volumes. We need to remember these questions. I'll come back to them later. So, Poneo, the 20th, where it is with us, the 26th. That's the hourly frame I have open, the 20th, somewhere here for some reason. I don't have the entry point, exit point marked. That's bad. Let's open Neo here on the 20th, and on my trading V, they're marked excellent. I can comment, well, for some reason, yes. I noticed that on the buy bit, it's good that the entry and exit points are marked. Generally, they are also marked, yes, but sometimes that's not the case right here. For some reason, there's no trade showing. Let me try to refresh the page. Hourly frame. Maybe it's because I traded a different frame. For some reason, it's here, but on this
intraday volatility, there are no points marked here. Really, the 20th, right? It doesn't show on the 5-minute either. This, by the way, yes, the first deal on NEO, it's just perfect, well, mirror image of all the previous ones, which I analyzed in detail in the last video on YouTube. We looked at one of these at the very beginning. And the next deals on NEO may already be a bit tricky. And as for the ideal deal on NEO, we have level, breakthrough, level. But also, overall, the market is upward, the trend is upward. Within an upward trend, within a day, it comes from bottom formation. And then a flat below the level after the bottom, that is ascending lows. And we stand flat below the level, broke the level, retest this level. This is the ideal entry point. I think this is where I was just going in. And we can see, yes, and P&L order history. When did I enter NEO? I'm interested in the date 20th. Opened a long eye. On the 20th at 17:53, at 17:53 I opened a long, what time is this? I wonder if I opened something here. No, it was already too high. It's probably the time here on the south side, but I think it's below.
Сделок, совершенных по стратегии какой-то, где вы вышли в плюс, хотя бы какой-то минимальный.
How much do I have UTC plus 6? And yes.
Знаете, как грамотно найти точку входа, причину сделки и так далее, когда вы будете открывать...
Yes. UTC plus 6 and 17:53. Then here it is, the entry point. Yes, exactly, it coincides. I'll show it now on trading view, since here I even have it stretched exactly across from my trade.
Если вы стопы ставить не будете, вы сольете депозит рано или поздно.
By the way, here is the bottom, a rebound from this bottom. This is me on the hourly frame. It is a little more compressed than there. It is open for 15 minutes. Here is the volatility. Here is the flat level, breakout of the level. Retest here, I entered. Stop, well, the technique will essentially stop working if, well, this is exactly such a reversal. If the price flies below this low for it, I just put a stop loss profit. I placed it, in my opinion, according to the highs. These are the reasons why I initially set it high. The profit is somewhere close to these highs, but as soon as the price went, I think I fixed it manually. I almost didn't wait until the take. Let's see, I fixed it at 2040. At 2040, yes, that's where I fixed it. Here the price went. I didn't wait until the take. In fact, it turned out perfect. I earned the first impulse, took it completely. Then the price rolled back. I could have earned more, but after sitting out this movement, I just placed the move there and sat and waited, like how I originally... I planned, well, after this impulse, in my opinion, I did not see any strength in the market. NEO shot then, and the rest of the market at that moment, in my opinion, looked so-so, and I decided to take the profit that was formed. Let's accidentally open some Ethereum Classic coin, for example. Yes, look, here it is, the rise of NEO. You see, it is synchronized by these, my cursor on the left-right chart. Here it is, takeoff on NEO. Here it is, flat takeoff on NEO, vertical, and somehow very sluggishly weak that Ethereum Classic went. The link is dying, yes, by the way, it fell significantly. The throne here is another pattern, and here the price didn't flat at all, yes. I saw that the market doesn't particularly react. There are similar patterns as in NEO. NEO came out quite strongly, did a retest, it immediately flew over the rest of the coins. I didn't see such strength. I took it. Didn't see it. I just caught the first impulse and locked in a profit, an ideal deal. As for the later ones, they were of worse quality, but they're indicative. Let's talk about examples, about risks. If you don't know how to trade, or if you haven't had at least 100 other transactions made according to some strategy where you at least came up with some profit, then you're clueless. You have no experience, you don't know how to competently find the entry point, the reason for the trade, and so forth. When you open your trades, you're most likely doing it, if not by guess, then something close to it.
Даже не учитывая то, что я в минусе, вернее, даже учитывая то, что я в минусе, и я говорю,
if you open trades there at random or close to it, the quality of these trades will be poor. If you don't play stops, you will lose your deposit sooner or later. Usually, you enter into a trade, a bad trade, you don't really understand what's happening. You're just trying to guess if the price is rising. They say it will continue to rise. I buy accordingly.
At some point, the price even went in my favor. I feel so great. Now I'm a trader making a lot of money. Then the price rolls back to my price and even lower. My nerves are already starting to get crazy. I had a profit. Oh my God, a loss is already burning. Everyone is saying it will go up. Okay, we sit. Wait, I won't set it. We have no stop. Then the loss increases. An idea arises. Okay, I'm kind of like, well, even if I'll lose, well, not much. I have $1 there. But by now, my losses are 400. Well, I'm already sitting there. It's like it shouldn't knock me out. The market, for example, is bullish. Everyone says it will grow. It goes a little bit against you, and you already think, I have $2. Let me average out these $2,000. My entry point will be noticeably lower, and I'll definitely make profit. Even if the price returns to the previous level, I'll be in the black and fix it there. Start it. Averaging has begun. You just have to throw in all the remaining money. As a rule, this already leads to draining the account. Yes, what led to the liquidation, but this is a common scenario. So I have the next two trades. The trades went to a draw. It's an indicative situation. In fact, I have three trades. Two of them are negative. One is positive, it would seem, but I should be in the red. But these two negative trades, if you count, they are roughly the same as this one positive one. This data is still enough.
Рисуют идентичные паттерны, и многие монеты уже вот в этот момент, когда Нео стоит вот здесь вот на дне, начинают...
Typically, the outcome is a little better, such as those $220 could have actually been saved, but overall it's a demonstration, meaning in these two transactions, I lost no more than what I made with the positive one. Do you understand what I mean? Anyway, let's go in order. Seems like these transactions of the 23rd should be marked on this chart, the 23rd. So let's switch to 15 minutes. I'm actually at around 5 minutes here or so. Is it 20? No. There's no 3rd, there's no 23rd. I'll have to come back again. By the way, this is a deal. It's about the same. It's also good. This is the first one in which I lost 150. Here I'm saying 200 couldn't have been lost. Let's look at it a bit more closely. I lost $150 on a pretty good deal, which is not even considering that I'm in the red, or rather, even considering that I'm in the red. And I'm saying that this deal is good. I saw it. I saw the strength in the market in the Ethereum class. No, in my opinion, with which coin? I'll say precisely now, I think with either Ethereum Classic or Solana. There was an identical pattern, an identical pattern.
Уже ретест, уже закрепляемся. Вот на правую часть не смотрим, да, что произошло в итоге. Но точка входа хорошая. Там подобных паттернов куча по рынку происходило. Многие из них уже пошли. Нео еще не пошел, начинает поджиматься, я чуть заранее вхожу. И что происходит? У Нео просто идеальный паттерн. Вот здесь и по другим монетам все не так хорошо, не так красиво, потому что где-то близко к верхам находимся. Откат был не такой значительный, не такой большой. Где-то упали там вертикально, какая-то большая волатильность. У Нео очень красиво с точки зрения теханализа. Раз, два, там тройное дно, восходящие низы. Вот этот паттерн уже себя отработал. Тут есть объемы высокие на покупку. Откупают.
So where is it? The 23rd, as per Solana.
Я взял именно его. Плюс он еще не вышел к тому моменту, когда я увидел силу по рынку. И взял. И смотрите, у Нео один из лучших паттернов. Одна из сильнейших монет. И она стреляет вертикально после пробоя уровня. То есть там чуть-чуть в минусе я посидел.
Yes, well, no, actually, the pattern is not exactly the same with Solana, but Solana is also a good example. Here is the bottom forming. What is happening? There is a double triple top in Neo, well, or there is a head splash, whatever you prefer to call it, but here it is at the neck level, downward breakout.
executed. With this pattern, it is trading downward at this value. The pattern executed, the bottom is here, the bottom is beginning to be bought, the coin is in flat, the market is drawing identical patterns. And several more coins already. This moment, when Neo is standing here at the bottom, they begin to come out from this bottom. That is, from Alan, for example, this is not an ideal pattern. I'll try to find another one. Maybe there was one. Now I'll go poking around, I'll look, and the coin is already coming out. That is, you see. But during this period, when the Solana came out of the bottom pattern, Neo was still here, only at the stage of its formation. So the Solana went, everything is fine. So let's go classic.
Рынок не пошел. Нео пошел вверх. Если бы по рынку действительно была сила, подтвердилась бы идея, Нео спокойно улетел бы вот сюда вверх. Да.
Yes, no, it was a little off schedule. It was a formation here. No, this is a very similar situation that happened here with Ethereum Classic. But apparently not Stellar Manor. I wish I could remember what exactly looked the same there, but it's possible. Here it is also the bottom. But it was formed together with Neo. Yes, 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 yes.
Если бы он стоял ниже или, допустим, его бы вообще не было, я был бы в шоколаде, потому что цена...
Yes, hell, pay attention, here it is also the bottom, and the level of the bottom, a breakdown of this bottom, subtract absorption, at this moment, pay attention when this happened, at this moment, Neo has not yet left the bottom level, there is already a breakdown, already a retest, well, we went a little lower, but they bought it, and there's already a retest. We're already gaining a foothold, we don't look at the right side. But what happened in the end? But the entry point is good, and there were a lot of similar patterns happening in the market. Many of them have already started. Neo has not gone yet. It starts to tighten up. I go around a little in advance, and what happens? Neo has just a perfect pattern. Here for other coins, everything is not so good, not so beautiful, because we are somewhere close to the tops. There was a rollback, not so significant, not so big. Somewhere some kind of high volatility fell vertically. But Neo is very beautiful from the point of view of technical analysis. 1-2, there is a triple bottom, an ascending low. This pattern has already worked itself out. There are volumes, high prices. The purchase is bought back. Neo was one of the best patterns then. For this reason, I took it. Plus, it had not yet come out. By the time I saw the strength in the market, I took it. Look, Neo has one of the best patterns, one of the strongest coins. It shoots vertically after the level was broken. That is, there was a little bit in the red. I sat there for half an hour. He immediately shot vertically after the level was broken. Pay attention. That is, this moment, this period, there was no hell there. There was no... At that moment, it didn't go. So he's Desh. He had a completely different pattern. What did we have from Solana or that ephemeral classic I showed? No, there's no ephemeral classic Solana, but Solana didn't go at that moment. But it flew away a little earlier, but not so much. There was no pump here. That is, one of the best setups of that moment gave an excellent impulse. The market gave a strong impulse, the technology was at a peak, thus the potential was close to the maximum. The deal wasn't built on the assumption that Neo is exceptionally strong, that the whole market will fall, but Neo will rise. No, the deal was predicated on an idea to enter a reversal pattern in one of its best manifestations on Neo, one of the best bottom patterns, and the whole market was supposed to lift off, the whole market should grow, and Neo should just grow faster, easier, stronger, and so on. I entered the market. The market didn't move. Neo went up. If there really had been strength in the market, the concept would have been confirmed, but I would have calmly flown higher, you see, because even without strength in the market, it is special. It flew here, the deal was a good one. But it just sometimes happens that in a good deal, it knocks you out. From a stop-loss perspective, I placed it here. If it had been lower, or let's say if it wasn't at all, I would have profited, because the price knocked me out and came back. But this is also not a key indicator, because it's a good place for a stop. Sometimes it happens that you get knocked out by the price after it comes back. It's okay. It's just part of the job. You need to accept that these moments are what you pay for the scenarios, but if you hadn't placed a stop, it would have just dropped vertically down -10% in 2 hours, and you would be left without a balance. It's normal. Yes, it seems unpleasant. It feels like you are at a loss. It seems like it started well.
But this is not a reason to remove the stop loss if it started well at the beginning, on the opposite. It is a reason to move the stop in your favor. If something happens to close at break-even, or if somewhere there is a level right here, you can even put a stop gain there. This is not a reason to remove the stop loss. This is not a reason to average somewhere. Yes, it happens, the deal is good, a good entry point, good logic, just unlucky. Sometimes unlucky, but the deal itself is good. Let's move on. The next one, in my opinion, was a bad one. Before I get into the bad deal, I want to go back to the chat. What's going on with the chat? What do you guys have to ask? My chat crashed. I don't see where I stopped. How much do you spend analyzing the market each day? About half an hour, perhaps an hour. CS or Dota? CS about calculating volumes, how to choose a coin? Yes, I will turn my attention to this later. Your take profit is 0.74, not 0.64 on the current deal. I'll review it at the end. It's not to say that I bet on it, I just raised it in case the price goes up sharply before starting the broadcast. In this case, before the end of the broadcast, when I analyze this deal, I want to analyze it in... Now, as it is open, we'll get back to it. I've been observing you for quite some time, but I only seem to be able to trade on Bitcoin. No other tokens seem to work at all. If there's some difference that I'm missing, could you give a couple of tips on trading alts? If you manage to trade Bitcoin, then stick to it. Alts have higher volatility, therefore you'll most likely have to lower your leverage, because if you can easily take high leverage on Bitcoin and set a stop, I don't know, at 100%, well, then, with alt, you'll have to deal with 100. If you set 1%, it knocks you out instantly. Alts need some breathing room, so to speak. More substantial, broader, with big leverage, this will lead to significant losses accordingly. Less leverage, well, with less leverage, there's a growth potential that seems to be higher than a win or the potential for falling in the event of a downward trend, but this all gets leveled out. All the potential profit is because you take a small leverage. If you take a large leverage on Bitcoin, in moments, you can even earn more, but you can't trade on alts. I don't trade alts. All in all, you jot everything down in a strategy, merely trade, and make money on Bitcoin. What's the problem? I'm teaching myself. I trade only on XRP. Is this normal, or should I try others? This isn't normal, and as I just talked about Bitcoin, only Bitcoin can be traded, only XRP. Why only XRP? Most likely you've chosen correctly XRP. It's one of the worst coins in general for trading, actually. Well, I just opened one. This is an exception. I'll look at it at the end, but listen, I don't even remember the last time I traded XRP. Maybe even this year. I have never traded. There is such a possibility, but I can't buy your training. Why can't I take the training? There is no money. I don't provide installments. I tried twice. Sad. Stops always work. Could it be that the stop didn't work? Stops don't always work if they are placed incorrectly. Essentially, this is how we place take stops. A position is opened. With this stop loss, we write here and here the entire position, and the last price at the last price, we write stop losses, which trigger on the market with a market order. Stops can be placed and limited there as conditional limit orders. Conditional limit orders can fail, there can be slippage. I don't want to stop now. It's better just to close on the market. Perhaps it's not the best price compared to a conditional limit order. You pay a bit more for it, but you are always confident that take stops will also work. There won't be a situation where you think you had a stop, you wake up, you're liquidated overnight, but how? I had a stop and there was slippage. You had a conditional order there, not a market order. There isn't any money, or rather this amount, so I can't go to training rights from Eruralsk. We have an installment plan based on trust. You can leave a request there too. We'll arrange an installment plan for you ourselves, providing the service without any banks or intermediaries. If there is a universally accepted index in the crypto market, similar to SP 500 on the stock, or if there is a ticker you compare with Bitcoin, that could be a guide. You can monitor Bitcoin instead of the SP, like a fund. We'll record this. So, how's everything going with you?
How's life treating you? Everything's great, right? How much can a trader at your level earn? About $10,000? Earning $10,000 a month is a reasonable figure. I have a small balance, I trade about 15,000. In an average month, I can earn 10,000 or more during a good month. I withdraw money from the exchange and live off it, paying mortgages and so on. If I didn't withdraw them, but focused on building the balance, I have experience trading $1 million. With $1 million, you can make another 1 million in a year easily. How much is that? You can earn about $80 a month. I have that experience. I haven't fully traded with $1 million for a year. I had $1 million there for just 3 months, but it doesn't matter. That's a significant balance. However, if you build on it or suddenly deposit a large sum, can you tell us why Solana has such growth? What is the reason for this? Well, it experienced a huge drop. It was probably one of the weakest coins. It just shot up from the effect of a low base. It fell there from 250 to about 7 or 8. 250? 8? Well, it saw a sharp increase and the pattern is good. It's a triangle. This huge triangle was the launch point. Here it was, the potential according to the pattern. It has just paid off. And now they are simply buying out of inertia. These vertical pumps, if they don't happen across the market, they end quite abruptly, possibly by 50%. Bitcoin may drop by 10 or 15% on any correction. Solana may roll back 50%, that's a risk, don't get involved in it, don't trade this, it's a gamble. So why don't you trade spot, then margin trading? There's leverage, letter B, commissions 10 times higher, letter C, inconvenient interface, letter D. Why trade spot if there are futures with practically zero commission, with a user-friendly interface, it opened with two clicks, closed with two clicks, stops, secrets, everything's set up. It's clear and understandable. Why do you need spot trading at all? Spot is purely for buying crypto and forgetting about it for 15 years. That's the only way. Why don't you trade? Binance is already available in Kazakhstan, but I have a Russian passport. I transferred. They told me they would remove me from Binance. They tell me I have to wait a year, but I didn't want to wait, so I switched to Babbit right away. I recommend it to everyone. When do the lessons take place and on what days? The lessons are recorded. We hold online trading sessions once a week. Each session can differ from the last. When you withdraw from the exchange, you pay a tax. I can go into more detail on this topic during training if you're interested. Oops, I forgot to leave a link to the training in the description. I've said before that if anyone's interested, I'll give you a link to sign up for the course. I'll post it in the chat now. Actually, I'll add it to the description of the broadcast right now, because I forgot to do it earlier. Come sign up for training on profitable trading. If you're interested, leave a request. We even offer installment plans. This means you can theoretically study for, say, 5 or 10,000 rubles a month. It's interest-free. So we pay the bank interest so you can study. This benefits many people. And the installment plan comes in, it gets approved for me. We offer a trust installment plan without involving banks. This just splits your payment into several parts. I'll talk about the program in a bit. I just mentioned it because I saw that the link was missing. But after adding the link, I thought I should mention it. I've been enjoying watching you since last year when you jumped into TikTok and started teaching compound interest in investments. By the way, it's interesting to get a table where you can enter your own values. As for investments, I'm thinking of also doing training on that, providing tables and everything. Are you using a logarithmic graph? Yes, but could you tell me now on Bitcoin in Vertex, do you think it will go up or not? I didn't quite get that. And I won't be looking at any coins right now. That's what you're writing in the chat. Perhaps at the end of the broadcast, I'll stress this point if you're interested, so stick around till the end. But now the main broadcast program hasn't been launched yet. I'm answering general questions about what I just explained. But beware. In my opinion, it may not work if there's a very sharp price movement. This is called slippage. Binance seems to write the percentage of price deviation from the stop price. If this happens, in my opinion, it may not work. But I could be wrong. A market transaction will go through. A market transaction, it will simply fulfill you according to the market. The problem here is just that maybe you bought, for example, here you have a conditional stop. I'm drawing this as an example. Yes, if the price hits here, you should ideally close at the stop. But if it's like this...
23 числа я открывал лонг в 03:45, это вот эта сделка, да. И еще этого же дня в 22:28 у меня был вход. 22:28, вот здесь у меня был вход, я вошел. Ну, по сути, что, идея та же самая. Только паттерн переформировался, двойной.
Didn't wait. Из минусов. Don't be sad. I'm not sad. Many were sad. Those who didn't know how to trade just watched the video titles where I said that Bitcoin is 3,000, Bitcoin is 10,000. Those who can't analyze or evaluate entry points were very saddened, as I saw in the comments. I won't tell you who I learned trading from, especially since it was a long time ago. These people, I occasionally look at them. They aren't feeling their best from what I can see. I learned a lot from many people, so I put together my knowledge piece by piece. No one gave comprehensive knowledge or a trading strategy. I created my own trading system. Please tell me if you want to make money, close your positions in Libertex for Bitcoin. And forget about it. What is the risk to reward ratio that you're observing? In 2-3 range, there are only 22 likes. Come on, people. Someone is sharing such important knowledge, but you only give likes, really? Likes? What kind of joke is this? I recommend the personal tariff to those who can afford the most complete service. Yes. Plus, for whom are you putting forth effort for free? On what time frame do you analyze entry into a trade? That's also a good question. Let me ask questions that require a lengthy explanation. Oh my god, I accidentally duplicated the same question in the chat. I wanted to write it down somewhere. Let me record it on another monitor. But what does volume mean? How do I analyze? How do I analyze volumes? There was another question, if I recall. Remind me, it was important. I missed it and I wanted to handle it later. I'll write it down so I can return to it later. Back to our discussion, back again. It seems someone asked about what kind of coins. I see that was a question. More on that later. Well, Neo?
Такое тоже бывает. Дальше. Я пробовал перезаходить в Neo. Перезаходить в Neo. Я пробовал это...
That means it was a bad deal. A bad deal. What type of deal was it? Unfortunately, I didn't mark it on the platform because it was marked here in my Bybit. This is another deal. This is already a deal on the 26th.
И вот это закрытие лонга, вот у нас sell 26 числа, но почему-то buy не написан где? Buy не написан где?
Well, let's take a look at the order history.
Давайте посмотрим. 26 число.
On the 23rd, I opened a long at 0.345.
А это тоже сделка на самом деле была так себе, поскольку я стараюсь все трейды открывать в пробой уровня.
That is this deal. And also on the same day at 22:28, I had an entry here.
Изредка я беру и отскоки в том числе. И вот это была сделка на отскок, и она даже не по безубытку закрылась, она закрылась в плюс.
22:28, here is where I made an entry. I entered, well, essentially the idea is the same, only the pattern has been reformed, it's a double bottom. And the downside, a descending low in a double bottom, ideally Lee should be ascending. And there in the market, it was like 50-50, there wasn't much strength. But Neo, he was strong enough. I thought that this double bottom could take off.
Here,
generally, like this, in theory, the bottom is trading. And from this level upwards, well, the closest one was here. I was banking on such a movement, and something, in my opinion, didn't go well. A false exit. We even secured a position at one moment, but immediately below the level, we couldn't punch it back. In my opinion, my stop got blocked here. It doesn't report where I was blocked, but I think that you can look here correctly.
$250.
Here is the exit price,
13,585.
Yes, I was closed here. Well, I was just stopped out by a bad deal. Why? Because the pattern is much worse. That is, here the pattern was perfectly excellent. here in general, something similar to a double bottom. The entry is very descending, super in advance. There isn't any strength, it's just that based on the past ups and downs after the level was broken, I decided that I could trade well. Generally, this movement here is very strong, but we just take off vertically, the flag is bullish, but just a stop before further growth and very clearly below the level. In fact, here, well, there was a possibility of such a vertical takeoff and similar movements, similar patterns I've seen there for the last month. Many times in the market, this was the expectation, but the price didn't work. Well, the deal was essentially much worse, by the way. It knocked me out, and the price went in my favor, ultimately dying. Well, it happens, but the deal turned out bad. In fact, it was simply not worth it. This happens too. Then I tried to re-enter Neo. I tried this too. I closed at break-even with $20. I closed on the 26th and closed the long on the 26th at break-even. This is the closing of the long. Here we sell on the 26th. But for some reason, buy is not recorded where? Let's look at the date, the 26th, 5/28, 5/28. And this is also a deal that was just so-so, since I tried to open all trades at a breakout of the level. You can trade a breakout, yes. So the strategy essentially boils down to this. And occasionally, I also take rebounds as well. This was a rebound deal. It didn't even close at break-even. It closed in profit, but I only bought a very small volume. Turns out it's 22.28. No, it's actually 0.528. Yes, that's where I got it. I somehow did it here, but unfortunately, I didn't save it. The drawing wasn't saved. And within the framework of trends, I took it and closed the upper edge of the trend here. This is a small volume deal. Average, I took it for fun to test how it will work. Overall, it turned into a profit. Obviously, it's small change. What's $20? But considering that my initial balance was only $300, $20 starts to seem like some kind of money. Then I broke even and I tried to short it. Yes, these two trades were indeed within this channel. I buy from the bottom edge, sell from the top, then sell from the bottom, buy. The entry point was bad. I didn't have time to take a position here. I opened the deal, but the price had already gone up. Turns out I bought here, or rather sold it somewhere here. It's already in the middle of the channel. They started buying back from here. It closed, by the way. In fact, if I hadn't closed, it would have triggered a breakout, it would have gone up, I would have earned a lot, but this deal was strictly within the parameters of a rebound, so these two trades were just rebounds within the channel, average trades. Moving on to Binance Coin, this deal is excellent, it's ideal. By the way, I showed it yesterday, the 26th. Yes, this deal was yesterday, I showed it in stories. Let me dwell on it now. What's happening with BNUSD?
Откупили дно, восходящие низы, поджимаемся, восходящий треугольник. Взял чуть заранее, пробоя не случилось, моментально цена упала, но стоп не выбила.
Here, by the way, I noted for myself, I think I also traded it today, or when was it? December 27th. Yes, today I also tried to take it, but it didn't go. We'll talk about that later. Here, I noted to myself that I need to get in for a breakout, but I entered XRP. You could have entered Binance Coin. You see this level. Only, yes, the same pattern level buyout from the bottom, breakout of the level. This is the entry point. But I don't like to get into this. When it takes off vertically, you're buying really high. I don't like it. But it went quite well. Here it states, buy, sell. Now, what happened with Banana Coin? It's the same thing as in NEO. I already showed it. Same situation. Overall, the trend is going up. The coin looks very long. And the setup is like this, showing it on the big one. I'm showing this one on a big frame like this, which basically is a cup with a handle or possibly an inverted head and shoulders. This is the assumed neckline level, a breakdown of this level, a small rollback, which was yesterday. This is where I bought. Here I found an entry point, an ideal setup on a big frame. We switched to a small one, and what we see under the umbrella of this huge super pattern, there's a within day rollback, just such a downward trend. It ends. The ascending lows begin. That's when the bottom starts buying up. In my opinion, there were still high volumes. For some reason, there are no volumes on the buy bit. This is a disadvantage, but in fact, not so. Such mediocre volumes, well, in general, the bottom is bought up. A clear level is formed for the breakdown of this level.
И вроде как у вас будет 99.99 прибыльных процентов прибыльных сделок, но вы потеряли весь баланс.
I was just taking a deal. Here was a breakout. I took it. At the moment, it flew against me from the minuses, but the stop did not hit. I think I left the stop here or not. I seem to place it for this low. The stop didn't hit, and the price moved in my favor. In my direction, it went perfectly, in my opinion. It just closed me down. No, man, I closed it off manually no matter what. I saw the impulse. There's more. But I see that the market did not go. Venus coin took off without a market. And, well, the same as before. I just took the first impulse, closed. But in fact, the impulse continued a little. It was still possible to take more. This trade brought in $470. It lasted for what, 5 hours maximum, maybe even less. Oh, okay, a little more than 8 hours. 8 hours, $400. From a small balance, this is a good example, a good trade, then a mirror trade, but on a smaller frame, on a 5 minute period. It didn't work. Theoretically, this is what the price could look like, huh? When a similar deal doesn't work, I also took it in advance. Here is a local level. This one is a little more important. And after takeoff, a rollback. We bought off the bottom, ascending lows. We're pressing in an ascending triangle. I took it a little in advance. A breakout didn't happen. The price fell instantly. But the stop was not knocked out, but came back. This local level is no longer particularly important. This one is more important. And unfortunately, its breakout did not happen. And they take me out. The smaller the frame you take, the more passing trades there will be. Remember this? How do I determine the frame? Here was a question for trading. Depending on whether there's something interesting happening in the market. There's nothing interesting happening in the market. There's something interesting happening on the market. Some kind of bottom, some kind of buyout, some kind of tightening, some clear levels. I'm looking at small frames with a search for a good entry point. Here it looked like a tightening, ascending lows, a level. But the price of the transaction did not go, the quality is worse. Well, pay attention to, it seems like it's 50-50, but the question arises, how to make money from trading if you have statistics of 50-50? Half are profitable trades, half are unprofitable. Well, a profitable trade is $470, a losing trade is negative 140, you understand? Yes, what it adds up to a profit of the trader. A trader does not have 100% profitable trades. You need to strive, of course, to ensure that as many of your trades as possible are profitable, but here it arises. The question is that theoretically there can be 100% profitable trades. It's just that if you don't record a loss, if you don't record it, it seems like it will never happen until you are completely liquidated by one single deal. Like you will have 99.99 profitable percentage of profitable trades, but you have lost your entire balance. And to prevent this, you don't need to strive for all trades to be profitable. This won't happen if you trade competently, but you need to strive for profit on profitable trades by loss of unprofitable ones, and there it brought you into profit. And so XRP, I closed today negative $70 long. I took on XRP and long I took on XRP here on a larger frame, and what happened here is also similar. Yes, you see we are falling. That is a rollback within the day. The bottom the redemption of the bottom, the ascending lows. But the level, it is not marked here. Let me mark it. Oh, that's not right. Here is the level, or maybe in my trading domain. By the way, it's marked. Let's come back here. XRP. No, not marked. Here's the level. Breakout of the level. I waited, saw the consolidation, saw that there was an upward trend. Here's a super important level. Here's a super important level. Me again, without waiting for a breakout, I take a trade close to this level. You see, yes, how much I like to go around a little in advance. Here it didn't knock me out. I closed here, in my opinion, manually. Why? Because I didn't like how the price bounced from this level.
Если будут какие-то разворотные паттерны по альтам, сила кончится у рынка, я это увижу и, соответственно,
well, you saw it, and there you go.
Эфириум что делает? Он просто вертикально взлетает, бычье поглощение, выше ключевых важных уровней. Эфириум — это следующая монета по счету, которая пойдет как...
I manually recorded a small loss of $77, and then I reopened it.
Один в один паттерн по эфириум, как у Solana, вот потенциал.
Actually, I can't remember why I decided to enter it again. Essentially, I just repeated the same deal at the same price, and it's what is relevant now. By the way, someone asked about the current deal. My entry point was 0.6295. The profit has decreased a bit. It was $100 during the broadcast, but now it has dwindled and has gone negative. For the stop, I placed it after these few peaks that touched the zero level many times. By the way, I like to put 0.6095 here. For some reason, I ignored it due to the round numbers at the bottom.
Сила есть, и вот так я смотрю на весь рынок. Вижу, что сила есть.
0.6095 is not there because it's too low, but you can put 0.6094. I like to place it under the round numbers. I set a high take, and as you see, the stop is wide, and I set a high take because the potential here is good. But for this deal, let me now show the next point in order to explain the logic behind this XRP deal. It is important to generally understand what is happening with the market now. Let me now answer the question. There was a question, which coins do you look at and on what principle? How do you generally look for a coin to enter? Let's see what's happening with the market. First, I open a broad frame, and in that broad frame, I just go through my watch list from top to bottom. I look for the market strength, trends, levels, patterns. You see, the watch list is on my right. You can simply copy it from me. These coins guide me. These are the top coins and a few coins that used to be in the top but are no longer there now. Then there are hype coins, of which there are a few. Based on all this, I make a decision, draw conclusions about the market's strength, look at some interesting patterns and levels, first on a large frame. As for Bitcoin, it is really just flatlining under the key zone, under the level, not far from the maximum. Here is something like an ascending triangle or some sort of pennant. Theoretically, if this trend line is broken, it can roll back. But if not, then we just lift off vertically until some point. Until there's a breakout or some sort of rollback, nothing has been said yet. The priority is to trade long, and if there are reversal patterns in the altcoins indicating that the market is running out of strength, I will notice this and abandon such an idea accordingly. Now, take Ethereum. What does it do? It simply lifts off vertically, showing bullish absorption above key levels. Ethereum is the next coin in line that will follow a pattern very similar to Solana. Remember the question about Solana? With her, why does she lift off like that? A pattern on Ethereum, identical to Solana's. That's the potential. But $5,600, it's not going to happen tomorrow. And it won't be the day after tomorrow. Yes, but in 6 months, quite possible. Look at Ethereum, it's taking off vertically. There are coins that just have this pattern, take off, vertical. You say Solana grew a lot. Over here, look, this is NEAR and BNB. let me remind you, it's the same perfect bullish pattern. Oh, and the confirmation of this pattern. There are golden intersections above the moving averages. After hitting bottom, we lift off vertically, we pass key levels through bullish takeovers. Binance coin was one of the weakest coins during this period, foreshadowing the market's fall. First, Binance coin dropped, and after that, the rest of the market followed. It was quite weak, and this coin now looks like this. It just lifts off vertically, a very bullish signal. But NEO, with a mega pattern below the level, could take off at any moment. There is strength to do so. I observe the entire market and see that there is strength. Bitcoin Cash seems to be in a flat, but from the bottom edge, it just shoots with ordinary absorption to the top line. There's another coin with exactly the same pattern. It appears to have rocketed recently, but I can't recall what it was. Not Link, something with the same pattern, it just took off. But I can't remember what it was. The coin, it may not have been on this list, so I didn't remember, but there's potential for the same exact pattern for Verge16G and Bitcoin Cash BCH. The potential for exiting this pattern is something like this. I saw a coin with the same pattern that had just flown here the other day, but apparently it's not on the list I have. In general, the market is bullish, so what do I do? If the market is bullish and I see that it has strength, then I trade. If I see the trend is upward, but the market has no strength, then I don't trade at all. I avoid the market. But once I've decided that I'm trading, I move to a smaller frame, 15 minutes or maybe an hour. If there's something interesting on the hourly chart, then I go to a smaller frame, 15 minutes within the day. And here, there are some other points here. Here, I'm already searching for some entry points, and I'm also looking for some investment ideas on a smaller scale, ones that prioritize long trading. This, of course, is according to the significant daily trend and what's happening on the 15-minute mark, somewhere around neutral, stepping out from it, also known as a bullish signal. Somewhere volumes are rising from below, they've been bought back very rigorously. This is the situation with digital currency. Like Bitcoin Cash, it has been soaring for the past 3 days. Dash is continually updating its local highs, and that's how I got here. Well, it's obvious, isn't it? That the market is strong, now it's apparent that it's powerful. Before this, it seemed average, and I see strength here as well. Now it's clear to everyone. And thus, I reached XRP and see a pattern identical to a series of other coins. Here is a stellar one. Similar, it's also not exactly one-to-one, but it's similar, and I noticed that XRP has not yet taken off. Here is the Link one-to-one pattern, and many other coins have already taken off, soared, vertically taken off. XRP with this pattern is still standing, and the level is under pressure. Due to this level, the pattern is perfect, the market is strong. There are coins that have already adopted this pattern, not yet. I enter into a trade, and the logic of the trade is that if there's a way out of this balance, that is, well, we could float again for a while. I'll wait it out for some time. But if there's a downward way out of this balance, well, obviously, there's no way to follow the pattern, so that's out of the question. I'll place a stop under the balance, that is, a stop is needed, where the logic of the trade ends. That's the potential for this pattern. Well, I set it very high. I was just focusing on this. It needs to be set lower, somewhere focusing around the maximum. But I threw it right here with our super high. This is if you sit too long. This is right if you sit too long. There is generally a huge risk-reward potential. This is not normal. I'm super heightening it. You see a negative 3%. Yes, and there's already 17%. I'm super heightening it like that. This is if you put some kind of trailing stop there or instantly move it theoretically. Or sit 24/7 staring at the monitor like this and move it manually. And in order not to miss the moment when such a situation happens and the coin collapses, to not be left without profit, well, as I say, you need to either toggle stop or be at the monitor 24/7. Ideally, put it closer to this. At this level, if some sort of conditional double bottom forms here, a deal will be secured. The risk to reward ratio here is good, with about a 3% loss and a 9% gain. This is a superb ratio. This is not an ideal deal, and the pattern is far from ideal. But there's logic here. The deal is good. It's worthwhile. It's not bad. The deal is an ideal, as I have shown you many others before, but it's good and has its place. Artyom, have you stopped logging on to Twitch? Yes, I switched to Twitch. That's true. Let's get to some questions. Who's online? I'll refresh the page. I don't understand. 20 likes, seriously? Or did I just not refresh? But 93, that's better. Come on, give some likes to guys who are online. Put a plus sign in the chat so that I can see how many people are active online now. Now I'll answer your questions and tell you about the training program. Just a reminder to anyone who just joined, I'm recruiting a third batch for trading training. I did not advertise it or announce it. Over 100 people wrote to me in direct messages expressing interest in the training. I went on Instagram stories once to say, whoever is interested, write to me again in a DM. And we sent a link to questionnaires to these people. I posted it on my stories once and haven't made any announcements elsewhere. But in case anyone missed it, and a lot of people will watch this broadcast on YouTube replay, if you're not following Instagram, I'm announcing for the last time the third batch of training.
Ну еще раз, я могу давать прогнозы, и они даже, я вот на Ютубе периодически это делаю, они у меня даже...
We'll probably fill it in the next few days.
Но, понимаете, да, это...
Let's get to train people in the third batch.
Мне вчера Ютуб давал рекламу XRP, а сегодня зашел, ты его лонгуешь, не ловушка ли это? Определенный сигнал от Вселенной, значит, тебе нужно срочно...
Now, how much percent does the income tax from the state take? Just a bit. Speaking of, is mom not sad? I'm really sad. Well, New Year should arrive any day now. Let's celebrate together. Why is smart money a scam? I didn't say that. I don't understand smart money. I trade price action plus volume spread analysis. Actually, everything I just showed you is price action. I didn't even touch on weight here. But the volume spread analysis is about volumes. Volumes too. Also hold weight and you should consider them. In my experience, BSA works better with bigger frames and there is more price action on smaller ones. But tell me, will there be a Bitcoin increase today or not? Give me a prediction, haha. Pay attention though. Our broadcast lasts 1 hour and 30 minutes. Throughout this time, I have explained the principle. A trader's job involves deciding entry points, stopping, and making profits. I haven't mentioned predictions because a trader can't see the future. Yes, I can provide a prediction by merely guessing, but understand that I can't see the future. A trader does not make money from predicting the future. A trader profits from understanding whether there are buyers or sellers in the market, the overall trend, the market's direction, its mood. If everyone is buying, the price will rise. I don't know to what extent, when it will increase, how much it will grow, or what the volatility will be. The price can rise gradually without volatility, or it may quickly surge. I don't know this. I simply open trades based on technical analysis and market mechanics. As for whether Bitcoin will grow,
без комиссии. Потому что на Binance я платил там, по-моему, 1 или 2% P2P комиссии. Не помню, по-моему, 1. Здесь без комиссии. То есть я деньги увожу, и с меня даже комиссию не берут. Это прям очень приятно. Как у тебя эмоции влияют на сделки, как это менеджеришь? Это тема для отдельного эфира, на самом деле. Если кратко, Ну, вот у меня сейчас под рукой нету карточки состояния. Я вот их недавно выбросил. Они, я их печатаю периодически. Они у меня файликами, ну, не файликами, этими листочками, тут бумажками лежат. Они мнутся, руки потеют, да, но превращают это в такую тряпку. Я это выкидываю и печатаю новое. Но вот не напечатал пока что. Новое. Карточки состояния просто, чтобы следить за своей психологией. Если я отдаю себе отчет, что, типа, какое сейчас мое эмоциональное состояние. Там, выкладываюсь ли я по полной, там, какое состояние стоит добавить и так далее. Вот я на обучение разбираю этот типа NLP.
It's quite effective, you see. It's about probabilities. Yesterday, YouTube advertised XRP to me, and today I took an interest. Could this be a trap or a sign from the universe suggesting that I need to make important life decisions promptly? You're looking at the old coins, but the new ones are shooting up. Look at the new coins. You can make a profit there. It's unpredictable, impossible to trade. These are shit coins. It's hype. Some kind of buying a Tesla in 2021 was a mess. It wasn't necessary. About AVAX coin. Maybe we'll sort out some of your coins at the end of the broadcast. Still in Kazakhstan, yes. Could one pattern potentially give rise to another in the near future? So, one pattern worked and is suitable for another? I didn't quite understand the question. Well, theoretically, yes. It would be better to clarify exactly what you mean. Where? You look at your transactions, this is a diary. Bybit is what it's called, it's an exchange. I switched to it, I recommend it to everyone. You can register using the link below, they will give you $100 for a deposit. Of course, you need to make a deposit of $3,000. No, if you deposit $10, you won't be credited with $100 in addition. If you deposit $3,000, you see $3,000 on the registration page. Deposit it there in the Bybit on Bitcoin, click on them, you get $100. Anyone with a lot of money, there's $250,000, my friend. You have a welcome bonus of $8,000. But can volumes be added in the indicators? Here on this chart, I'm only showing you this chart basically. I'm not looking at it, I'm looking at the transactions, I'm looking at the chart with transactions. I open a trade here, and the indicators are here. Yes, you can add volume, let's add Will. The volume of beauty will need to be configured only. Why I switched to Bit? Because Bain said that in a year, all Russians accounts will be closed. And for new ones, newbies no longer open accounts, Bybit is leaving, and oh, Binance is leaving, or rather, Bybit. The commissions are the same as on Beyonce. They are low, and the liquidity is slightly less than on Binance, but much better than on other alternative options on other exchanges. I really liked that there is P2P without commission, because on Binance I paid the, in my opinion, 1 or 2% P2P commission, I don't remember, I think it's 1. Here there is no commission, that is, I'm withdrawing money. They don't even take a commission from me, it's really nice. How do your emotions affect transactions? How do you manage it? This is a topic for a separate broadcast. In fact, in short, well, I don't have a status card at hand right now. I recently threw them away, I print them periodically, I have them in files. Well, not files, these paper sheets, they're lying here as pieces of paper. They wrinkle, my hands sweat, and it turns into a rag. I throw it away and print a new one, but I haven't printed it yet. Get a new today card just to monitor my psychology, if I'm aware of what is my emotional state now, am I doing my best? What state should be added and so on, so I'm sorting it out for training. It's like NLP. Well, you probably can't call it NLP, but well, I sort out these moments. If I realize that something is wrong, I close everything, leave. And if I open some kind of deal, I understand that it's complete crap. What did I even do it? I already realized there, after the fact, for example, I closed the deal, to hell with it. It doesn't matter whether it's positive or negative. For example, I closed the deal afterwards. It doesn't matter, it's up or down.
Больше на вас будет внимание, больше акцент будет на вас, чем на ребят прошлых потоков, потому что у них уже есть база.
I deviate from the schedule, but no, free training will not be for just one person.
Результатах научить вас отвечать на ваши вопросы в первую очередь, но в целом посещать эфиры.
To avoid waiting for Ben's arrival, it's better to go straight away. Don't worry, it's true. Yes, how to get $100 for a deposit on Bobbit. You'll see the conditions there from registration. Well, it doesn't show up here. These are my rewards. Take $100 if you deposit more than $3,000. You can get $30,000 for a deposit there if you deposit $250,000. They will charge you $30,000, but you need to trade high volumes there. If you deposit $3,000 there, you just need a trading volume of $6,000. That is, just by clicking on Bitcoin once and sitting down once, it's done. And if you donate $100, there's a $2 commission and $100 on top. How different is the current exchange rate from the 2020 rate? Plus 4 years of experience, well, there are around 3 to 4, depend on your perspective. Are we talking about the beginning or ending of the year 2020? Yes, 3 to 4 years of experience upwards, the market does change periodically. How can you arrange a payment plan if it's a bank? As you said, leave the application on the site. And by the way, I surely forgot. I was talking and lost my train of thought. I wanted to show you the program, to tell you about the training. Look at Profit 3.0. This is the third stream. For those who lack knowledge on the subject, I've been training and trading. I have done enough for investments for a long time. Well, the last two streams, and now there will be a third one. Not counting the previous two streams, my last trading training was at the end of 2021, or quite a long time ago to be more precise. So, I resurrected this idea this summer. I had some thoughts before, but I was too lazy to actually update the information and guide students. If you looked at my social networks on Instagram in particular, I wanted to do training last year too. However, I was lazy, so I collected my thoughts and strength. The first session was this year, the second session was 2 to 3 months ago, and there have been results and cases already. The third session will be soon. The program starts on January 3. Theoretically, you can sign up before that. The program will run for 12 weeks, which means the training will last for 3 months. Please note that the training consists of video lessons with homework plus a trading session. The trading sessions will be held online. When the training comes to an end, after 12 weeks, homework will no longer be checked. However, you will still have access to the platform depending on your subscription. More so, you will remain in the community group indefinitely. We have trading sessions, and individuals from the first stream often participate in the second stream. We don't prohibit this, as it enhances the learning process. Even individuals from the first and second stream can attend your trading sessions. More attention, however, will be given to you. The reason for this is because these individuals from previous streams already have a foundational understanding and have already seen results. Therefore, we primarily focus on nurturing your results and answering your questions first, but we don't discourage you from participating in live streams and other streams. In essence, you will always have access to the community. This training is suitable for anyone, whether beginners, employed individuals, or students. It's even suitable for entrepreneurs. You can look at their cases on Instagram and reach out to participants like Buren. Unfortunately, he doesn't have a social media network, but you can ask him questions. If you are directly interested, you can write to them. The training program consists of the following stages. I give a complete introduction from scratch, and even if you are unfamiliar with markets and do not have any idea about crypto. If you don't understand how the market operates, this will be completely useful to you. I start from financial literacy basics, without which you can't succeed in crypto trading. If you lack an understanding of the basics, handling and managing finances, and don't understand risk control, you won't succeed in trading. This is crucial, as there are individuals who attempt to trade without understanding the basics. It will work out. So, I highly urge everyone to go through this process. Even if it does seem like, what is finance, financial literacy, why do I need it? I kind of want to start trading already. No, everyone. Be sure to watch the lessons. They are very simplistic. They are not long. They are concise. Using presentations. By the program, you will have summaries. There will be homework for you to reinforce the materials immediately. Now, I won't delve into the title of each lesson. Here's the first module. It is dedicated specifically to economics, financial literacy, In fact, I even provide information on the principles of increasing income. On the side, if you work a side job, you might even climb the career ladder. Well, I glance over this a bit, and then the entry into cryptocurrency comes. I explain what is crypto, how it emerged and how it is structured, how it even happens, essentially the fundamentals. What is crypto? What does it look like? And this must be understood in order to... You need to understand that to competently assess the long-term prospects of crypto, there are certain bitcoins and other alts. This is important. In addition to understanding how to handle the script, there may be considerations like where to store it and so forth. And if you decide to invest in it long term to buy it, we'll need to discuss the services required for market analysis and other things, like how to read the news correctly and where to do so.
Вася Пупкин, мне 45 лет, у меня трое детей, родители обеспечивают меня, много народу зависит, у меня много ответственности, много обязанностей, риск профиль у меня будет совершенно другой.
We'll also move on to technical analysis. Technical analysis includes analyzing the chart, searching for an entry point, and some attempts to predict the chart and the rate as far as possible. But as I always say, the trader does not predict where the price is going, but theoretically, one can make some assumptions and build future work there. Trends, indicators, what works, patterns, candlestick models, volumes, that's all part of price action. I'll go over all this in the module about technical analysis. In short, how to analyze the market, you'll understand. After that, we'll go on to risk management, how to control risks, trader psychology, stop loss, take profit. I provided a lot today, simply out of benefit, not everything that is given in the course. The course is succinct, very point by point, the lessons are brief but without any fluff. The bulk of it is in a couple of lessons from risk management and it can all be contained in about half an hour. All the information that I've provided for you right now, which took almost 2 hours, the time increased because I would often get distracted and read some questions in the chat. But in essence, I spent this entire broadcast talking about stop loss and take profit. I only touched upon the principle of setting a stop a little. I didn't talk about the principles of setting a stop at all, only showed a couple of examples. I also briefly mentioned status cards. Who is interested in these? There was benefit from this broadcast, but it's not yet over. Give a thumbs up if you found it useful so I can understand your thoughts and so you understand as well what the content of the training entails. Here are a couple of points from the module on risk management. I've talked a little about the technical analysis, but still showed some thoughts on the schedule and a couple of points from risk management as well, so you generally understand the content of the training, how comprehensive it will be. Did the moderator send the link in the chat or in the description? Anyone who looks at the recording and the trading system, this is something that no one will ever provide you in any other course, anywhere on YouTube, anywhere on the internet, you won't find this. The trading system provides step-by-step, clearly written rules on where and how to buy, where and how to sell, where to accept losses, and where to take profits. I'm sharing my trading strategy, my trading system. It works, and I'm also instructing you on how to tailor it to your specific needs, because after all, everyone has their own risk profile. You might have your own perspective on risk, which is constructed at a basic level, and you will understand this after watching the first module about financial literacy. Why does it work like that? For instance, say I'm a 22-year-old guy, no family, no kids yet, essentially no one really depends on me. I have some money, I have some income, not necessarily from trading, but I have some side income. I start trading, my risk profile will be different. My risk profile will be completely different if I'm a 45-year-old guy with a common name like John Doe, with 3 kids, my parents support me, a lot of people depend on me, I have many responsibilities. You see, at this basic level, the trading system, the trading strategy, might be as similar as possible, but in this case, simply because we are different individuals, our risk control will be a little different. I'm telling you how to adjust it for you. And there is a bonus module at the end about investing in cryptocurrency, how to invest smartly for the long term. Maybe someone made money from trading and wanted to invest long term, or maybe someone just wants to invest, even though they've taken a trading course. Suddenly, they realize trading may be too complicated, or they have too much money, don't want to sit in front of the monitor looking for entry points. They just want to buy and forget about it. I'm telling you how to do it correctly, what strategy to employ. It's like a bonus module, just saying, I have a lot of experience in investment. Although I don't invest in cryptocurrency per se, I do have various portfolios. There was the stock market, real estate. I have also made small investments in cryptocurrencies in the past too. I know how to invest wisely passively, and I'm sharing this. There are different tariffs according to your financial situation. You see the prices on the screen and note they are reduced. That is, theoretically, you could have signed up a little earlier, but at a more expensive price. And this price is, well, theoretically, if you wish to sign up after the third day, and if we have places left, we will accept you, but at a quite higher price. Depending on the tariff, we have a different number of seats. For the start tariff, for example, are not limited at all, because the start tariff offers no feedback at all. Take note. For the starter tariff, for example, there are absolutely no seat limitations. Why? Because the starter tariff doesn't include any feedback. And note that there are no trading sessions. You will only see them recorded. This is not a complete training. We don't offer investments in cryptocurrency. There's no trading system. Basically, this tariff is for those who still haven't decided whether they want to get involved in trading. It's simply a chance to observe it from the outside. But if you've watched up till this point and now you are here, I wouldn't recommend this tariff to you. It's definitely not for you. But consider it at least. The optimal tariff, on the other hand, does include feedback. This is full-fledged training. I provide the entire trading system, my trading strategy, and your trading sessions will be included here. 8,300 per month in installments, it is clear that you can join for just pennies. If you don't want to installment plan, it's interest-free. We pay the bank on your behalf. I've mentioned this before. You study and we pay the bank for you studying. They don't charge exorbitant interest. You've seen the entire central bank rate. It's horrifying. This is such a gift from us. Many people choose this option to not freeze their one-time capital. Then you pay little by little and trade. You may have a total of 100,000 rubles. Yes, you will trade with it, pay little by little from the profit. It's very profitable. So for those who don't like installment, you can pay up front. But click here, sign up, enter your details. If you have any questions you want to discuss, there's more specific information, and our managers will contact you. Just leave a request. Here's the premium tariff. This is the thing. What's the optimal way? Only I will be here. There will be more trading sessions. You'll have a separate premium group. That is, from the optimal one, you will get into the optimal tariffs chat. There will be guys from previous streams, premium. There will be guys from previous streams who is in this group. Here, people have more money, and the results are slightly better, simply because there is initially a larger balance. Usually, I'm present in the chat. I write in the chat. Answer, you can tag me there to ask something, and I can suggest something. I hardly sit in the optimal one. I just drop a couple of important messages a month. Premium is a chat with me. The optimal curator there is Misha. He's even a good person in the chat. Premium is with me. I don't broadcast all my own deals. I'll say right away, these are the midterm ones. I broadcast what I open within the day at 15 minutes. This doesn't go here. This is such passable material. I give only clear deals here, medium term, long term ones. I finish a couple of deals a month there. Here in the premium tariff, I will personally check your homework, and homework checking by the curator is in the optimal tariff. Well, it costs more, there are fewer places, obviously. As for the personal supervision of Pervushin, the most expensive tariff is for those who have a large balance up front. And we have two people there on this tariff. And note that trading sessions are even for premium. Here we have calls once a week where we communicate with you live. These take place in our Zoom chat, and we have a separate group chat. Apart from these, everything else is the same as in premium. So, if you sign up for a personal one, you'll also be included in the premium group. In it, Maxim and Vlad work personally, and they are also in premium. They communicate with the guys in a separate chat, and you'll get to speak with me directly. Please note, there's an installment plan that is calculated as a percentage. Once again, if you want to reserve a place and are afraid that the number of seats will run out, or that we will raise the price, press the button to make an advance payment. These conditions will then remain with you. Of course, you'll have to pay the outstanding balance before the start of training, but the seat will be reserved for you. As for the content of the training, platform aesthetics, and extra materials, there are tables, and that's exactly what regards the tablets there, and status cards. This is a bunch of additional materials, along with a community of like-minded people, which I think is very important. I focus on this group and declare that you will remain in it forever. This is crucial, because no matter what happens in the market, no matter what is going on in your life, you always know that when you go to Telegram and open it, you have a designated chat with like-minded people who will support you in difficult times and celebrate your results with you. This is a highly significant factor, and without it, there would be no results. Yes, it's possible, but it's not ideal. I'll answer questions in the chat just now and also show you an analysis of transactions. You get support from me. Here's a little information about me, and I'll often answer your questions. I'll put the link in the chat now where I'll answer your questions. Let's discuss the training now, and then we'll come back and discuss any remaining queries about the market that you might still have.
Естественно, у тебя есть какая-то идея, как только идея пришел конец, все, крестная сделка, закрываешь, не боишься.
Let's start from the very bottom, because I've лost track of where I stopped at the top. You'll have to take the personal supervision rate to get in touch with me. I'm also in the premium chat, so theoretically, you can go there and tag me to ask something, for example, if you wish to work personally. There's also a call once a week and personal supervision, so I'll personally review your diary and tell you what's good and what's not. To correct your vision, yes, this is personal. When you start trading during training and go through technical analysis about our 100 modules, most people start trading with us. I emphasize that you, technical analysis, well, before trading, you'll be scared of everyone. Yes or no, but we usually don't approve of this. The first attempts are already underway here, but you won't have yet. You may not have a trading system yet written down point by point, but you will already have made some first attempts. If you've never traded before, naturally, it's best to start on a small balance. I strictly suggest, until there are positive results, until there is positive statistics, to allocate no more than $100. Once there is positive statistics for those $100, you may increase the amount according to your capabilities. Therefore, you're not at great risk, even if you don't have a trading system in place yet, but you're already making trades. So out of KZ, 5,000 is optimal. This is the standard amount. Prices are in rubles. Prices are in rubles. Yes, 5,000 is optimal. This is the standard amount. I understand. Now, you wrote this in Tenge on our website. It is 500 rubles in dollars, depending on the bank's exchange rate. Hit the payment button. The exchange rate will be written there. There is an opportunity to pay from abroad, but just now it says gone up. Let's see what's there. Well, a little bit. Yes, the pie chart shows $136. Look at the price on the website. I've noticed this and I won't tell you again. Go to the site. It's cheap. The course is cheap. For the material that I give, it's almost free if you're upset. Once you pay, consider it practically free. It's important to just understand what you're paying money for. You're paying for the experience for which I paid for 1 million rubles. This experience brought me tens of millions of rubles, and you're buying my time. You're buying the most important thing, a strategy that no one else will give you point by point detailed. You also purchase video materials with a clear, understandable explanation of how and where, explaining why it works, where and why it won't work, when you don't need to use it, how do you adjust everything to fit yourself, restructure it. I also talk about personal finances, including how to get out of debt. That is, for any situation regarding finances, here you will get answers. I understand that if you don't work it out, then you don't hang up until the victory. This is a good lesson. Naturally, you have some kind of idea. As soon as the idea is over, the entire deal is closed, you close it, not fearfully. It's very beneficial, brother. Thank you. Could you tell me, is it possible to simply invest in cryptocurrency, figuratively speaking, holding the same company's money until it increases in value, and then take profit without directly trading on the exchange? Yes, you can, but in this case, you need to study the principles of passive investments, because most likely, you will not invest passively. You will want to play on the fluctuations in the course, already switched to trading, and if you don't know how to trade, then you might not lose money. Yes, but you certainly won't earn more. The concept of passive investments, jot it down and study. It's not simply two lines on the internet saying passive investments you bought and forgot. I want to do training on passive investments. Next year, I'm thinking about doing a separate video course. There will be material, perhaps a little less than in a trading course, but there are quite a lot of nuances to the subject. Passive investing isn't as simple as you might think. But in a nutshell, you bought and forget. Don't try. You can play on the course, why not? But you won't have money in the moment, not in 20 years. Let's say your goal is to save for an apartment. You can save up for an apartment through crypto, you'll have it in 20 years. But this is about income in the moment. With trading, it's specifically for income now. Regardless if the price falls or rises, it doesn't matter. You make money in the moment. When will I start earning money after starting my training? I have $600. Should I go for premium in installments, or is it better to get the optimal tariff? Who knows? Who do we have on the broadcast now who was trained by me in the last streams? First stream, second stream, write a C in the chat. Is there anyone sitting online with us now who took the training? Write a seat in the chat, please. How long did it take for you to start earning money? Misha writes about the second month, just to be honest. If we have someone online now who is from previous streams, write in the chat, please. After how long did you start earning money? Repeat the link. The link has already been repeated. Tell me, can you just invest? I read this. Oh, so how much money should be prepared for homework? I don't understand the amount in the sense of money. You trade for training with $100. As soon as you get good results with $100, we have training cases. Who from $100 raised their deposit to $1,000 and more? Here is Leosha, for example, and updated his information. I posted a link to an interview with him on Instagram. We recorded with him. After the first stream, he earned money for a laptop with $500. Then did something else for $500 on top. He bought a laptop. Now he's earned $20,000. We updated the information, so he earned $520,000, ramped it up. You have a case with $100? The guys ramped it up to $1,000. So theoretically, you can stay with $100 and multiply the amount. But initially with $100, you least you don't get a big result for these $100. Then you replenish as much as possible. And if you didn't get a result with $100, you trade until the end with these $100 until you get a result. But if you have $10,000 in your pocket, you don't jump to $10,000 until you've learned how to trade with $100. And as soon as you've made $200 from $100 and consistently managed to make a little profit, you don't immediately move to $10,000 if you have $10,000. You gradually increase switching from $100 to $500 once you've made a trading profit from $500.
Если ты про какие-то прошлые обучения, у нас там полтора года назад было обучение по арбитражу, и ты его не прошел, там были определенные сроки, до какого числа...
I left Russia and paid taxes on profits while living there.
Ну, ты не прошел, ну вот, извиняю.
If you're interested in how to pay taxes on cryptocurrency, join the training. I'll show you how. Do you think it's worth opening an account with Binance for diversification? I'm currently trading on Bybit, but why not sit and trade? What's this diversification you're talking of? What if the exchange closes? That possibility is extremely low. It's a likely scenario if you have a lot of money lying around. In theory, you could, but it also depends on what passport you hold. Binance might not be the best option if you have a Russian passport as they're leaving Russia. There's some closed group with Signals. I don't like Signals because they don't work. Let's take a simple example. banal in its simplicity, you just don't think about it. But here's an illustration. Two different individuals, the same strategy. Let's say the strategy works. The strategy generally works. I'll also show that it accelerated from 300. Now, here are two different individuals. A 20-year-old guy, he has one kind of risk profile, and then there's a 45-year-old man with a family, children here and there. A lot of people depend on him. His risk profile is completely different. They'd carry out completely different transactions at completely different times using the same strategy, even on the same balance. That's why signals don't work. Have you ever heard that someone made a lot of money from signals? No. I tried giving signals in the year 2019 or 18. It doesn't work. Now I'm in training, bear in mind, I emphasize again, the plan, starting with the premium plan, is Artem Pervushin's deal. Do you consider these to be signals? If you think so, then here's the answer to your question. But when I throw in some potential deal, I say that you don't need to replicate my deals. Here's an example to consider. If the deal is not in your favor, will you wait until the stop, or will you exit for your own reasons? I wait until the stop in 95% of cases. Occasionally, I might not wait and close early. In half of such situations, I usually regret it later. Were you planning to buy a house in Almaty to rent out? I was thinking about buying in Astana, not Almaty. It's part of the idea I had in my mind, how you can apply for an installment plan. If the bank doesn't grant it, submit a request, and our guys will contact you to discuss it. By the way, a few people who have been learning in the chat wrote within a month or two, in a month. Well, the answer to the question is yes. When will you start earning money? The guys from the previous training wrote within a month. In a month or two, I have clear supervision that you cannot answer me regarding arbitration. I deleted my query above. I did not go through any training, but I paid $150,000. We will return to base options. If you are talking about past training, we had an arbitration session a year and a half ago. You didn't attend. There were certain deadlines until when video lessons would be available for you while you didn't attend. I'm sorry. Sorry, it's your problem that you didn't find time for it. I'm a professional athlete. Games, everything I can do, trading. The desire is the main factor, wish, and of course, time. If you don't have time, if there isn't a free hour a day, then maybe it's not for you. Well, everyone has a free hour a day, I think. You can do trading in the long term. I just showed a small short-term trade in the course of this broadcast. You can do trading in the long term, then you can spare an hour every few days. Theoretically, yes, the main thing is the wish. The main driving force is the wish. Let's jump in fearlessly. Let's sort out the answers. I will analyze the questions you asked me. So, the next thing, first, I've already sorted out a big question, like which coins do I look at, in what order, and how do I decide to enter into a trade? And what time frame do you analyze trade entry on? I wrote it down separately for myself, but in general, I already answered this question, didn't I? Inside, not these transactions that I showed. These are all intraday. These are from 15 minutes to an hour. Well, 15 minutes an hour. That is working intervals or 5 minutes, 15, time, 4 hours, day. These are all of 6 hours, 3 hours, 2 hours. We don't look at this. These are the exact ones. You can write down 5 for yourself. 15, time, 4 hours a day. Well, theoretically, just a minute. Yes, like 1, 5, 15. Well, just a minute. You'll quickly lose your deposit. Don't meddle here at all. You will also drain the 5 minutes, but not so fast, at least for a minute. Well, 15 minutes is already such a standard intraday. Mainly it's 15 o'clock, that's what I demonstrated with the deal, it's mostly 15 o'clock, out of which, in my opinion, a couple of transactions were at 5 minutes. Depending on some levels, if there's a super local level, there you take a smaller frame, It simply won't even be visible at this level on the hour clock, what is visible on the 5-minute clock. For example, if some level is more important globally, you take a larger frame, there will be more stops, more take-ins, you take a smaller shoulder. Although the same thing is viable, the main thing is not to flirt too much with huge shoulders on a small frame, like don't take the 10th shoulder there, but okay, the 10th is still tolerable maybe, but don't take the 20th shoulder there on a small frame with a very short stop. Meaning, it seems like you're losing a little, yes, it's like there's 0.3% of stops. You take on a lot of leverage, it seems like you're losing a little, but it's just 0.3% of stops. You're taken out with a probability of 99.9%, you'll make 100 transactions like that, and you'll end up at a serious disadvantage. The main thing is not to flirt. With small frames and large leverage, that's the key. But you can make money in the first trading session with the curator. I regret that I missed the first session, Evgeny writes. But it's okay if you missed some of the first sessions because there will always be entry points. Yes, this missed profit in the past may seem offensive, but don't dwell on it. Mainly, it can put a lot of pressure morally, and if... So, don't focus on this resentment that you missed some entry points. You could get into bad entry points based on emotions. It's best not to focus on this. Is it important to understand that there will always be entry points, the market will always fluctuate, there will always be some trends. The market will not always stand still like that. It won't just swing back and forth in some kind of chaotic way. There will always be trends, there will always be patterns. The market will operate as it did in the past. This is how it functions in the future, always. About the entry point, the main thing is not to enter into a transaction based on emotions. But let's clarify, people who started earning money in 1 or 2 months, did they already have any experience or is this starting from scratch? Oh guys, who did you talk about and who is now on the broadcast from previous trainings? So, you mentioned 1 or 2 months, please clarify this point. Did you have any experience before this or from complete scratch? Can you tell us about the volumes of the glasses? But about the glass, no, that's not necessary. I don't use the glass even for scalpers. But about the volumes, yes, that's what time frame I answered this question on. I had it written down. The next question is written down just about volumes. I'll analyze the volumes now. Is it possible to learn something from books? And if so, what kind? Now, I'll first answer these smaller questions of yours and then the volumes, because there you'll need to show a lot in examples. And from books, you can learn technical analysis. Which ones I don't know. Google technical analysis for dummies. There are patterns in whole that can be used in crypto, but you must take into account that what is written in the book was applicable in the past. In the present future, it's not a fact that it will be relevant. It's important to understand the interpretation of some patterns at the moment is what is relevant and how it is executed. Well, some kind of foundation will appear for you, it won't give you much at all. You will simply understand at best.
To understand why the left side of the chart was formed, how the right side of the entry point chart will be formed, how to control risk and where to take profits, books won't answer these questions for you. You need to adapt to your risk profile, but you need a specific trading system. You won't find a trading system anywhere at all. I say go through any other training, they won't give you a trading system. I have seen offers from others who didn't go through any training. Well, no one will give you a system. The book can help build some kind of a database. People who made money, they usually have optimal tariffs or higher. We have very few people at the start, and I don't recommend starting. It's just with... To get acquainted with the course, and we suggest that everyone who got acquainted with the course at the start should still consider the opportunity to go for a higher tariff. Because the start is not quite a full-fledged training, it's just so you can study spending a few thousand rubles. Yes, if you take it later, well, 5,800 rubles a month, just for a few pennies, because if you don't have any money at all and you want to have such an opportunity, it's not quite complete, as there is no shopping here. Systems? No, there are no trading sessions. but there is no online, no trading system here. So this is purely informative. Many people don't go there. This is for such a small slice of people who really have no opportunity. Usually people have the opportunity, but lack the motivation to go. They just wonder, is there any point in starting? If you have the opportunity, it's not an extreme case. It's better to at least go for the optimal one, I recommend. And binary options, what do I think about them? What's my opinion? Binary options are a scam. 15 hours is normal for those who trade. And if you work for 8 to 12 hours, then on what frames? 4 hours, you can take it calmly. Your deal will last there in days and days, maybe 4 hours a day, like a day. Your deal will last for weeks. You will have such long-term ones, such intermediate long-term one. I don't regret points. There's just a lot of interesting, important information given at the sessions, and you can watch the recording. Trading sessions are published on our platform if anyone misses it. So let me remind you, now I'll give you a link to this site again. Let's go to the chat. Let's go. I'll answer a question about volumes. Here's the link to the chat again. Volumes mean how to work with volumes. This is dedicated to that. A lot of training material is dedicated to this, but I'll attempt to briefly describe the fundamental principles of how I work with volumes. We are not going to cover these horizontal volumes. I usually do not pay attention to them at all. On YouTube videos, you can see mine where I usually turn them off, or I may have already turned them off. Usually my graph looks like this, and occasionally I compare the levels and check them. You can set the level using them, but we're not talking about those right now. We're talking about these. I primarily use vertical volumes for two purposes. The first is to assess how strong or weak the market currently is. That's the first point. The second point is to look for confirmation of a pattern. Perhaps we should start with the second point, which I can explain fairly quickly. There are several patterns, the formation of which and the subsequent is deeply intertwined with volumes. For instance, a descending triangle pattern. Such a pattern will always have volumes that appear like this, like this. Ideally, if there is some sort of anomaly happening, I don't know, like this, for example, but let's disregard that part. If such an anomaly is occurring, then I approach such a pattern with caution. There are several patterns that have a specific pattern in volume that should be present, which is necessary for this pattern to function. For example, in the case of a triangle, the volume should decrease in the beginning when volatility is high in the triangle. What is a triangle? It's volatility decreasing within the pattern. Initially, there will be a large volume with high volatility, which will then subside. Because the volume subsides, the market anticipates an exit from this pattern, and that's precisely why volatility fades. Typically, this is a singleton pattern. People are not opening new shorts here. The price has already plummeted. Why would I short at the low? Am I a complete fool? No. Whoever shorted may be gradually closing their positions, but closing shorts translates to purchase, which in turn pushes upward. The primary volumes have been worked out. Everything gradually quiets down, the number of sellers drops, and there are slightly more buyers than sellers. So the price begins to rise. But there are still buyers. But not so many as to the price immediately took off in a V-shape. Of course, sometimes the price moves powerfully like that, but it happens rather rarely. It's standing sideways now and the seller completely leaves. Here's a certain level, a strong one, a large seller who can't drop his volumes on their market because the price will just skyrocket. He would lose a lot of money on this, so he has set his limit. Everyone who remains in positions, who shorted there from above and did not fix it here, they pull their stops here. Here, a kind of density is formed that needs to be brought back in order to move forward. There are no buyers, buyers are gradually declining, so a similar pattern is formed. But it doesn't always break through upwards, it could go downwards and the volumes will already move at its exit. It didn't work out, but if there is an exit from this pattern or there's a reversal, everyone who is here is quiet, a suddenly large volume occurs, perhaps not immediately, maybe there will be such a retest, and then a large volume, and immediately the price takes off. If there's no such character, a volume of a similar character, it is much less likely that the pattern will work. Briefly, this is one case of volume usage. There are certain patterns, you need to know how to distribute volumes within this pattern. As for how I view the market from a volume perspective, let me explain the following point. Firstly, please note that my volumes are set up in such a way that they are initially, if you go to trading, or my volumes are not set up. Maybe I've just added them, and here they are, in red and green columns. It might seem to a beginner that the volumes are divided into buyer and seller volumes, as if green means buyer, red means seller, but that's not really the case. Any candle like this. Specifically, any volume represents buying and selling, so what can we infer from this? We can infer that, for instance, we have an upward trend within the framework of the channel, the price is rising and the volume is average, so what does this imply? This means that the price is rising, which means there are more buyers than sellers, that is, within this average volume, which doesn't change much, there are buyers and sellers, but in terms of percentage, there are slightly fewer sellers than buyers, which causes the price to rise, obviously, and from here it follows. So, what follows from this? For instance, is our volume increasing or not? Let's imagine a situation like this. The volume is decreasing, it's going down, and the price continues moving in the same channel. What does that signify? It means there are still more buyers than sellers, but the total volume has decreased. This implies that there are barely any sellers left at all, and very few buyers. The structure is unstable. Why is that? Because all it takes is a seller to walk in. You don't even need some super large seller, the price simply increased. It seems more attractive to sell here than there. At any moment, a seller enters, even for a relatively small volume, and this situation unfolds. There, the volume is taking off, the trend is breaking. Do you understand? Yes. This is how I analyze the force, simply based on a small fact about a decrease in volume. And if the volume decreases, and the price starts to slow down at that moment, the situation is slightly better. Because here, the buyer and the seller are evenly split, 50-50. It's simple, then the buyer can step in again, and thus the price is restored. Of course, the scenario here can also be different, but it's nice for the buyer. All they need to do is buy at a lower price. There's a greater chance that the buyer will return, rather than if the price keeps growing without volume. It is unlikely that there will be any sizable buyer activity. The higher the price, the more likely if there isn't volume, it's growing, that it will all crash down. Let's look at the situation. If the volume, on the contrary, is increasing, I'm talking about an uptrend example, yes, but actually it also works in the case of a downtrend, only in a mirrored direction. For instance, the volume is increasing, there was a volume like this, here it went like this. If the trend continues in the exact same direction as it was going, what does this mean? It means that there are still more buyers than sellers, though the overall volumes have increased. That is, for instance, here it's 60% buyers and 40% sellers of this volume. Here too, 60% of the volume is buyers, 40% are sellers, there are still more buyers. Here is the buyer's volume, at the top is the seller's volume, but in absolute terms, there was practically no seller here. Over here, they have already appeared. It's worth giving it some thought. That is, a seller has already started appearing here. Do you understand? Yes, if.
как изначально вот нашла канальчик. Видите, что выходим за верхнюю грань канала, то есть ускоряемся, вообще вертикально тут полетели. То есть объемы высокие, продают больше, чем здесь, да, но и покупателя здесь гораздо больше. То есть это в целом пойдет. Вот эта картина не говорит о том, что он вот моментально сейчас рухнет. Ну вот монета, что это, DOT, в восходящем тренде, тут уже начинает закругляться, но видите, объемы чуть уменьшаются, просто рынок ждет. Если бы тут объемы были высокие, ну вот относительно вот этих, на которых росли, например. Тут, правда, другой вопрос, что вот здесь объемов особо не было, да, вот тут они уже появляются, но это, там, если сравнивать большие совсем фреймы, сколько дней это уже прошло. Да, вот если внутри дня вот это вот смотреть, ну... Объемчики тут были, вот на этих движениях покупали. Здесь начинают продавать, но на объемы меньше.
There seems to be a buyer too, but the seller is already huge. That is, no one was selling here. Then they started selling, they started letting go. Somewhere down there, someone was recruiting, but the price went up, they are already starting to sell and let go again. The price potential there means it's very bad. That is, the market is sweet. Here are just a few examples. How can this be interpreted in terms of volumes? There are some special situations you need to look at, some special cases to understand how it is and where to apply it. Well, for example, there are volumes. Volumes are increasing, the price is soaring, the buyer is big. Let's look at it further. The price has been growing, now it's decreasing, falling. Volumes have decreased, this is normal. If there were large volumes here and the price is going down, I would say that they are generally selling out here. But it's practically impossible that it will fly higher. It will only go down. However, it can easily fly higher here. No one is stopping it from collapsing in 3 hours. Theoretically, this is still possible, but the picture as a whole will be normal. The average volume is somewhere in the flat, a little higher there. There's not much special to say, for example, in the salon. Volumes are high at highs, the price has stopped growing, exit from trend. The salon is being sold out, you can clearly see from the salon that they are selling out in volume. Damn, it was standing there on the side. The volumes are starting to go up. There is, but in general, for such volumes, the exit should be a strong coin. Bigger, of course. Here, the seller is big. Enough, there is a high probability that it's just inside the channel. Well, the buyer has come, and the seller is also big. We approached the upper edge of this channel. Here is such a channel, like false takeaway, false breakout. But there is also a local level. Here we approached it. There is a high probability that we will return to where, back, let's say for Adi, but for Bitcoin Cash, they took off in large volumes, the buyer is big, everything is clear. But for Dash, the situation is controversial. Volumes on the one hand are starting to increase here at highs. On the other hand, you see there's a rounding, it goes vertically. If I draw trend lines, for example, like this, yes, I draw the trend line. It originally went like a channel. You see that we are going beyond the upper edge of the channel, we are accelerating in general. We flew vertically here. The volumes are high. They sell more than here. Yes, but the buying, well, there are much more buyers here. That is, in general, it will go. This picture does not mean that it will instantly collapse. Well, here's a coin. This pillbox is in an upward trend. It's already starting to wrap up. But, you see, the volumes are decreasing slightly. The market is just waiting. If the volumes here were high, well, relative to these ones on which they grew. For example, here the truth is another question, that here there weren't much volumes. Yes, here they are already appearing, but this is there if you compare very large frames, how many days have already passed. But if you look at this inside the day, well, there were volume traders here. They bought on these movements. They are starting to sell here, but in smaller volumes.
Начну разбирать сделки, сделаю акцент на следующем моменте.